and speak to them, speak to their heart, and speak tenderly to them. He advises the prophet how to talk to his people tenderly. The prophet said, well, what shall I tell them? What shall I say? Tell them, service is over. It's time for rest. On the Sabbath, on Sundays, on Sunday morning, we come for rest. We come to hear what God will say to each one of us and what he will say collectively. And it's the task of the preacher and the choir to speak tenderly and cry out, thus says the Lord. And that is what we've been thoroughly enjoying from this choir, that they have been crying out what God has said to them inwardly, introspectively. God has been saying to them, there are some people coming on Sunday morning who had some tough time the past week. And I want you to cry out to them, speak tenderly to them, and sing to them, that they might know the comfort of the Most High God. So we come indelibly to this place that God, that we can hear comforting words from the Lord. We come to hear from through his Spirit, speak to our hearts and speak to our mind because of what has transpired all week long. So thank you, choir, for speaking to us, comforting our hearts, and comforting our minds, that we do need blessings from the Lord every day. So on this Saturday, we meet at this station to hear this wonderful music, to hear wonderful music from this choir. Well, many of us have had despair to attach itself to our lives. And we look for the choir to become the first aid station that we might come and have our wounds attended to.
Yes.
Because we have been wounded in one situation or another. But here is first aid station that we've come to be attended to, that we can hear from the Lord. So it's important for the choir and for the preacher not allow themselves to collect a lot of dust in their life. And I talked to Joy early on. A while back, the organ had not been played. And it had some problems. Joy said, you know, we need somebody to look at it. I found a fellow to look at it. And he said that, the only thing I can find that's wrong with it is that it's been sitting up a little while and there's some dust. It's on the tube. All right. And it's keeping the sound from going where it's supposed to go. So the next Sunday when George played, I said, George, anything wrong? He said, no, it's all right now. Dust. Not rehearsing, not praying, not reading God's word, not listening to the Lord, it's dust.
when you get the dust off. Yeah. You get the tubes cleaned up. Yeah. You can hear the songs of Zion. Yeah. And you can't sing if you don't know the melody. Yeah. You gotta have a melody to know how to sing. So you have to watch the director to learn to keep the words and to stay on track. Amen. That's what the director is up there for.
Right.
To keep the choir on track. So our heavenly director will help each one of us choir members to keep the dust off and keep the melody on your lips. And you can sing with melodious voices. You hear the choir trying to sing from that practice. Some singing one thing and some singing something else. You don't have the melody. But if you watch the director will keep you in tune. The director knows when you're out of tune. I don't. It just doesn't sound right, is all I can teach. But the director knows the notes and the music and the songs and the words and so on. And the director can keep you in tune. So if you know the Lord, if you serve him, you can sing his melodies on Sunday morning. Amen. Because he will keep you in tune.
Amen.
So sing, as Paul said in the book of Ephesians, sing melodious song. Sing spiritual song. Sing heavenly music. And that's what I like. When we're singing for the Lord and not for self. But we're singing to declare his glory. And you can't do it if you allow dust and other stuff to collect in your heart. Oh, but you can sing to his glory. Because you've been in training. And anybody who tries to sing or preach or pray, and listen, and you can tell it. You can tell it. If they haven't been in the fire, if they haven't been in the water, if they haven't been in the valley, if they have not had a mountaintop experience, you can show enough to them. Because all of us, but no, let me go back to, I think that's in Revelation, where they said that there was 144,000. And they were singing a song that even the angels couldn't sing. And I thought about that, well, how is it? Angels don't know what human beings are saying. And then I thought, I said, well, there has to be something to that. And I looked at it again, and it dawned on me. Angels have not had any distresses in their lives. Angels have not had their feelings hurt. Angels have not had any sickness in their life. They have not had anybody talking about them. They have not been abused. They have not gone hungry. They could not understand what the 144,000 was singing about.
Yes.
The 144,000 were singing about where they came from.
Yes.
Yeah.
That I've been in the valley.
Yes. Yes.
And I stayed all day.
Yes.
I couldn't hear nobody pray.
Yes.
But the Lord
yes.
heard my cry.
Yes.
Angel never cried.
Yes, glory to God.
All right.
But God put the 144,000
yes.
in valleys.
Yes.
In rivers,
yeah.
in storms,
yes.
in ups and downs.
Yeah.
So when they got to heaven, no wonder the angels couldn't sing with them because they'd never been down.
Yeah.
But the 144,000 had numbers that had been down
Glory.
And nobody
yeah.
could pick them up with Jesus.
Yes.
So when you come to sing, you can sing because God had you in the training school.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yes. Preach.
Yes, sir. Glory to God.
Let somebody hurt your feelings.
Mm-hmm.
And let somebody say something about you didn't like.
Yes.
And you had to cry.
Yes.
Things didn't go well.
Yes.
See, that's training.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get mad with God.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get mad with anybody. But just tell it to Jesus.
Yes.
And then when you come on Sunday morning.
Thank you.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Y'all know which way I'm going now.
Yes, sir.
If you've been studying and training all week long.
Yes, sir.
When you come on Sunday morning.
Yes, sir.
Unlike the angel.
Yes.
You can sing like the angel.
Yes.
And you can get the highest note.
Yes, sir.
Because you know what the Lord has done for you.
Yeah.
And you can tell somebody on Sunday morning,
yeah.
I don't know about you,
yeah.
but I know what the Lord has done for me.
Yeah.
I've been up
yeah.
and I've been down,
yeah.
but the Lord
yeah.
has done something for me.
Yeah.
And I know that God will
yeah.
touch your heart.
Yeah.
I know you can feel it
yeah.
deep down on the inside. Store up some comfort.
Oh, yes. Thank you,
Lord. For somebody.
Yeah.
Yes.
I noticed the other Sunday, Idris, your grandbaby, he was making some noise back there. And the daddy couldn't do nothing with him, and the granddaddy couldn't do nothing with him. But the grandmama went back there, and she gave him some comfort. I don't know what you said. I don't know what she said. But when I looked at him, he was looking up laughing at him. Comfort. On Sunday morning, somebody come from a hard week all week long. Somebody said something on that job. And if you don't have any comfort, to give to them. It ain't worth coming up here.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have some comfort,
yes.
I tell you this, you see somebody getting up way back there.
Yes.
If you have some comfort,
yes.
you see somebody getting up way back there.
Yes.
If you have some real comfort,
yes.
you see somebody getting up right there.
Yes.
If you have some showed up comfort,
yes.
you see me getting up.
Yes.
Because I know what you go through.
Yes.
And all of us
yes, sir.
Will go through a lot.
Yes.
But if you've stored up some comfort
yes.
in your music,
yes.
you've stored up some comfort in your song,
yes.
on Sunday morning,
yes. Yes, Lord.
You don't have to make up stuff.
Yes.
God will give you what
yes.
you say.
Yes.
You don't have to worry about how it's going to go over. The Lord will take you over.
Yes.
And the Spirit of God will get on the inside. inside. Yeah. And somebody will feel it over there.
Yeah.
Somebody will feel it over here. Yeah. And I'm showing up from here.
Yeah.
Right here. Yeah. If you give me death, I know what the Lord will do.
Yeah.
Show up.
Yeah.
Come.
Yeah.
Show up. Trouble I see. Nobody knows the trouble I see. Glory, hallelujah. Nobody knows the trouble I see. Nobody but Jesus. Then she would say, glory, hallelujah. She has stored up in her life a song of comfort.
Amen.
Nobody knows the trouble I see. When we get to that point in life, you don't have that music. And when you come on Sunday morning, you ought to have that song.
Yes.
Nobody knows the trouble I see. She said, sometimes I'm up and sometimes sometimes we down. Nobody knows but Jesus. And then she says, glory, hallelujah. Nobody knows but Jesus. But she can always say, glory, hallelujah. Store up comfort. That whenever distresses come into your life, You can always say, well, nobody knows. But Jesus.
Yes.
I'm going to always say, glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory to
God.
Can you say that?
Yes.
Can you say that? Can you tell us that? When you come on Sunday morning. Because many have had ups and downs. But when we leave, we want to be able to say, glory.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
The door of the church is open. And there might be somebody today who need comforting from God. He has opened the windows of heaven. And he sent an only begotten Son to give to us strength to comfort the restlessness in our path. Is there anything too hard for the Lord? No. Nothing is too hard. As the choir was singing, there might be somebody today who would decide that I would give my life